IFRS.
Something like what the Lagos State government is doing.
Yeah,
looking at everybody says a single throughput for all the agencies in Lagos State. There's no hiding place.
Yeah, you need to do that. Before government has to get that right. Now, when you come in there, then you come, maybe you could have a committee where you come and defend your expense, or maybe on the court of the basis and say, this is how I want to spend. But as long as people have the right to spend, and it's enabled by the law, and these are one of the things we need to sort. The Fiscal Responsibility Act says that you put up some agencies, you can spend, then you can come back and
give us that act was passed by the National Assembly. Did it?
Yeah, it was passed by the National Assembly.
That says that some government agencies can generate revenue, spend what they like out of it, and bring back the balance.
And bring back the balance. You even get 20% of the balance.
Oh, and that sounds like a good accounting process, yeah, doesn't it?
Because
you can imagine a company allowing the staff to just spend whatever they like and bring in the balance into the accounts department.
Because the right approach should have been the National Assembly should have scrutinized effectively the budget or the expenditure pattern, but that's where the ball is dropped, and that's where even the account, because most of these guys, the audited financial accounts should be public also. You should be able to say, this is X amount I generated. Let me give an example. National Pension Commission last year generated 5 billion naira, spent close to 4.9 billion naira, and remitted just less than 100 million naira to the federal government account. So your question is, there should be a target. In fact, we don't even need a target. We just need to print all this money to a single pool and let everybody come.
And from there, you decide, you defend what you want to do. Whether you're buying cars, or you're repainting the building, or you're paying for a new rent, or you're changing furniture,
or
you're changing the type of tea and coffee that you take in the office.
Yeah.
Okay, now, that's the federal level.
Yeah.
Now you said, well, it's a little bit better at the federal level. Let's talk about the 36 states and the FCT.
Yeah, that's more challenging because apart from Lagos, that you get some level of transparency in terms of budget implementation reports and you get audited statements. Most states in the country are in a closed state. You would say, okay, go and meet the civil servant. But when you get to meet the civil servant, there's a toll gate in that space already. The civil servant, you ask in front of a question. Why would you need the whole
information?
And that's where the challenge is. And that's why we are in this mess with most state governments. Because when the debt service to revenue was rising in the years, nobody was computing that. That data was not available to inform the people.
No, we're ramping up bank loans, ramping up debt, bonds, overseas loans. Nobody talked about it.
When you're taking local bank loans, when you're taking facility with the local banks, trying to pad up salaries and make sure, nobody saw that. Now, when the banking systems are close to you, when they've gated in a funded, we can continue in this doom loop. Then we have
there's a revenue slump.
Yeah, there's a revenue slump. And so for example, a state, you take like 3 billion naira from FAC, you have like a 1 billion naira deduction for fees on your bond, the money eats your account, the local banks take another 1 billion naira, then you're left 1 billion naira. So what do you do? So the question is, most of them, this sense of secrecy is what has brought us to that point, where nobody can raise the red flag
So we need a massive public sector finance restructuring.
Yeah, we need, and the president promised this in his speech, when he says even up to things like the joint
President Buhari.
President Buhari. Muhammadu Buhari. Up to the joint accounts, he was going to open that space up. We need a public transparency code, you know, when it comes to public accounting. We need to understand that the whole entire process, the budgets, the expenditure patterns, the audited statements, the implementation pattern in between, the procurement spaces, we need to open all of that up. It's only if you're buying a nuclear machine or you're trying to tell us your ministry strategy, you can say, okay, keep that, we don't need that. But if you're going to buy for schools, hospitals, you're going to build roads and things like that, these are not information to be careful with.
So tell us about your struggle for freedom of information. You've been very active on the social media. Almost every day you're raising the red flag. Tell us about how much you've gone.
I think with the NAS, it's blinking positive. Now that we have
Bukola Saraki in place,
we have a committee and we're looking at how far does that go. The RMEFC also is also trying to put up a public circular now to say people should submit memorandum.
The revenue mobilization.
So people should submit memorandum of how much they think the National Assembly or even the entire government structure should have, the president or the vice president, in line with current realities, revenue, and the rest like that. So we're also trying to drop a memorandum. But something you find is that if you go by the Revenue Mobilization Allocation Fiscal Commission books and say this is what a person is entitled to, and you compute the figures, you find that it does not add up. For example, you look at the National Assembly, you check the RMEFC figures, a senator should not get more than 78 million naira in 4 years, which is like an average salary of 1.5 million naira.
Okay, 78 million naira for a senator divided by 4 years.
Yeah, yeah, 4 years. So,
okay, that's come to about...
it was going to be like 18 million.
About 18 million naira. That's what we pay a senator per year.
Yeah, yeah.
So if you divide that by 12 months, so it's got about 1.5 million naira per month. That's what the average salary of a Nigerian senator should be. Okay, Nigerians can afford that, can't they?
Yeah, we can afford that. But
for full-time legislative
yeah,
work.
Yeah, but by the time you multiply by that the number of senators, and you multiply by the number of the House of Rep members, you find out that the figures are not even up to 10 billion naira. So what do we do?
With 120 billion or 150 billion.
Or 150 billion. Extent, as it was before. So the question, that's the space to be opened up. And that's what we need to get more mileage. Where people need to understand public finance, until we get transparency out.
Until public finance becomes public.
Yeah, until it becomes fully public, as it is, should be. Because it's public for account, it should be public. Until that gets public, we can't go far, even with the war of corruption or our sensation.
Because that's how it all started, anyway.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, thank you very much. Sure, awesome. Nibudi, thank you for your time. We appreciate it. Right early on Monday.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, despite the late scheduling of that. Sure, Nibudi, the CEO at Budget.